Tomorrow, voters head to the polls to pick the Democrats running in the recall elections for state senators.
In District 8, Sandy Pasch is up against so-called fake Democrat. Her name, Gladys Huber. 12 News' Shelby Croft is live in the district. And Shelby, this is unknown territory for all of the candidates.
That's right, Kath. Sandy Pasch was here knocking on doors on the east side today. And while she's facing Gladys Huber tomorrow, she says she's always only been running against Alberta Darling. But a local political expert doesn't think it's that cut and dry.
Good evening. Good luck.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Sandy Pasch hit the streets again Monday, letting people know she's running for state senator in the recall election, letting them know there's a primary Tuesday.
It's unfortunate that they've sort of turned this into a joke by running someone who won't open her door to anyone who is really wasting time and taxpayer dollars.
Pasch never expected to have a Democratic runoff. Gladys Huber, an Alberta Darling supporter, is on the ballot as a so-called fake Democrat. There's been no publicity for her. Still, former state legislator and UWM professor Mordecai Lee says don't count her out.
I think there's the possibility of an upset tomorrow.
So-called fake Democrats are on other recall ballots as well, an unknown political situation. Another unknown heading into tomorrow, voter turnout.
It's going to be a weird turnout, probably unrepresentative.
Lee says low turnout generally leans right.
Somebody is more likely to vote if they have a higher income than average, if they have higher education than average, and if they're older than average.
While Pasch will be watching the results intently Tuesday, Darling says she's not even paying attention.
I'm not thinking about the primary at all. I'm going to be out in the neighborhoods talking with voters tomorrow, as I will every day.
Darling has been thrown into unknown territory as well. The veteran politician never thought she'd face a recall and finds herself explaining why she's knocking on doors in the middle of summer.
People are confused about is, you know, what is this campaign about?
Pasch says she's explaining as well. She says she's taking Tuesday very seriously and says it's given her 4 more weeks to campaign.
We are really testing out a system, and so it does give us a trial run.
Now, Mordecai Lee thinks a big reason for low voter turnout is the fact that it is summer and a lot of people are on vacation. I noticed today that the campaigns are offering absentee ballots when they do make those campaign calls. So everyone out there realizes it's a very tough time for an election. Reporting live on Milwaukee's East Side, Shelby Croft, WISN 12 News.